Well, hello, welcome once again here on Fashion Trendz here on Stream Africa. We talk about everything fashion, guys. Like I said, from your wear, your makeup, your shoes, name it. We talk on this corner today. I'm super, super excited on today's topic. Come on, guys. It's for the guys. Yes, this is for you. Talking about tie. Remember when I was in university days, some of those the engineering department, they say, come on, I don't like tie, they don't wear tie, just put on jean and pull it off to go. Some people say, I don't like putting on tie. Why? Tie makes it to look more gentle, a perfect gentleman that you are, even if you look rugged, but putting that tie, like, oh, this guy look very good, make you look classy, look amazing, at least for the working class people. Even if you say you don't like wearing tie, for your wedding, you must wear tie, either you wear the bow tie or the normal tie. Some say you don't like tie, you have a gentleman should also have one or two tie in his collection. So come on, you are not complete as a guy without a tie, please don't come for me. That's very, very, very stupid for me. So talking about tie, so no matter the type of work you do, a gentleman should have tie in his closet for interviews, for occasions, for events, for cocktails. So it depends on the particular event and the type of tie you should put on. Yeah, I remember in the university, it's my first day, BNK 101, I couldn't forget that very day. That was the first day of entering the university. We all came to school, actually, yeah, you know, that we all want to put on tie. Normally, like those in the banking department, the man stepped in, we were like, what is going on in this department? Nobody was putting on tie. See, all of us, we can't get tie. That's the first thing we should learn how to do today. So the following day, we all came up with our tie. So then knocking tie, learn how to knot tie and all that. So it's very important to have tie in your closet, one or two. Very important. So today on the show, we're talking about different types of ties we have. Yes, we have different types. We have like 8 of them. Yeah. 8 types of ties for different occasions and for different reasons. So the first one I have here is the 4-in-hand necktie. Yes, that's the tie. This tie, most of us are familiar with it, although it is a type of kind of office kind of tie that we wear for formal occasion. This type of tie can come in variants of weight, colors, patterns, materials. So the options are endless. Knots are another way to add some spice to this classic. I mean, you can wear this one for normal, you know, for formal things, for going to your work, or if you have an important meeting to attend to, you can put on this particular tie. Like I can see on the screen right now, it's a very nice tie for you to put on. But what I don't like this tie is the weight for me. I can't wear that kind of tie. I'm sorry. The weight is too... But so I'm still love it anyway. In case you're wearing your suit, you just button up your suit and you look still good. But wearing only your shirt and wearing that particular tie, it's a no-no for me. I won't wear it. I don't like the weight is too much for me. Now, the second one is the 7-fold tie. A close cousin to the 4-in-hand tie, this tie is made from a square yard of silk that you get folded 7 times. What they call it is folded 7 times because of the way this tie is made of. It doesn't have a lining, but it is thick, meaning that you can form a really nice knot with very little effort. This type of tie is gained from the office, from my outfit, and all that. But for me, this 7-fold tie is not for me. Mm-mm, it's too big. Now, I'll tell you what I would like to wear. That one is not for me because it's very big. But for some people, like those in abroad, the Americans, the London people, they might put on this kind of tie because it suits them and their weather. I think so. So they wear more than often over there. But here in Africa, it's serious people wearing this 7-fold tie. Now, it's not working anymore. Then my best tie, I love it, the skinny necktie. Something like this I'm putting on. It's a skinny necktie for you. Everybody, you have to have this in your closet. As a gentleman you are, you have to have it. If you're working class, you have to have a skinny necktie. It's another variation of the 4-in-hand tie. Skinny tie become popular in the 50s and in the 60s with bands like the Beatles wearing them on stage. This tie is very good and very stylish. You can just put it on. It suits for every event. It suits for every occasion for you. So I think the skinny necktie is for everyone. It's a must have for everyone. Just have it and just keep it in case you don't like wearing tie. Just buy it and keep it. One day, something may happen. Just get it and put it in your closet. Another one is the Western bow tie. Yeah, now when you talk about bow tie, we have different variant of bow tie. The Western bow tie is that first one that came out that is very, very big. You see it, even yourself, you cannot even like to wear it. That is it. Western bow tie is so big. You wear that one for not for some occasions, not every occasion, because the bigness of it. It's beautiful. I can't even wear it. So that's another kind of tie. We have the bolo tie. The bow tie became quite popular in the 70s and have been worn over since then by baby boomers who like activities like goat panning, catchers, and all that. So you see, like, the same family with the Western bow tie, but it's a little bit slimmer, a little bit cuter than the Western bow tie for me. Then we have another one. We have the cravat. This cravat is mostly wear, just like a kind of a handkerchief, but you just put it and you just tie it somewhere behind you or here, depending on how you want to put it. So this one is formula for those that want, that you can wear jean and wear shirt and just put that. Your style just look different from me. I love that style. It's very nice. I still in vogue, I'm still wearing it. So I recommend that one for you too. But this one is mostly worn in England. So, but in Africa now, we have seen that it's a fashion. So, we started using it here in Africa. So, please can try the cravat tie. It's very, very nice. And the eighth one is the neckerchief. This one is very nice, though, because this one is trending now. Like now. It is trending. But most people that only wear this one, where this one started is from the scout. The scout guys, because they wear something like that and do not tie. So, that's where that one originated from. So, we're now turning to fashion. So, you can wear normal pant trouser, wear your shirt, you can also tie that, add some flair to your outfit. You don't look too corporate for you. You just put that on, look really amazing and look good. You can also wear polo and put that on as well. So it depends on your fantasy and what keeps you going. So like I said, we have 8 types of tie. You've heard all the 8 types of tie listed here for you today. You have to know them. We have the 4 in hand necktie, we have the 7-fold tie, we have the skinny necktie, we have the bow tie, we have the Western bow tie, we have the bolo tie, we have the cravat, we also have the neckerchief. So the 2 popular tie that we use mostly here in Africa or in Nigeria, say, in the skinny necktie and the bow tie. These are the 2. Now, let me differentiate the bow tie for you. Is if you're going for cocktail, you're going for dinner, you know, you have your loved one, your babe, want to take your babe out, you know, wear your suit, put on your bow tie, you look amazing, looking gorgeous, you go out to have dinner, or you have some, you're invited by the presidency or the governor for dinner, kind of tie you put on. Please don't go and put the bow tie and go to office work, please, you look ridiculous. Sorry, don't even try it, please. The bow tie is meant for cocktail event and for dinner event, very, very important. Now, for the skinny necktie, it's for office work, like what I'm putting on is the skinny tie. The skinny tie can also wear the skinny tie for cocktail, but it doesn't go too well for me. Cocktail is cocktail, dinner is dinner. So wear your skinny tie for your office work, for your corporate events and all that. That's what it is meant for. So these are the 2 basic ties that we are familiar with here in Nigeria, which we all use mostly here in the country. So we'd like to go on a break. And when we come back, I will teach you how to knot a tie. And this is very important for a guy now. How to knot this tie, very important. In case someone asks for an interview, it may happen, but it's just not the tie you're looking at. Don't know how to do it. So let's go on a break, and when we come back, I'll teach you how to knot a tie. So stay with us. Alrighty, welcome back. Before we went on a break, I told you about the 8 types of tie we have, but the one we are combining here is the skinny necktie and the bow tie. So then I'm going to teach you how to knot the skinny necktie. Yeah, we have different way of knotting this tie. You can put it in your neck and start knotting. But the one that makes it easier for me is you can put it in your hand like this. This is your tie. And also it depends on how you love your length of tie to look like, to be, in case you want to knot your tie. So the first thing first is, this is the first stitch. Yeah. This. And all you have to do, you have to take it in here. You bring it out. Yeah. Draw it like the first turn. Now the second one, let it go here, and you bring it out here. See, we have having a shape gradually. And the last stage, you just put in your thumb here, and you just roll the tie like this. Put it in here. We are good to go. Your tie is ready. So very simple. As a guy, you have to knot this thing. It's very, 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 very important. I mean, imagine your baby say, you don't know, come on, you look so much. So you don't know how to knot this tie. Very simple. Like I said, you can put it, you can knock it, putting it on your head and knotting it. You can hold your hand and knot it. Depend on the one that suits you. If you want it to be more bolder, that like the bolder one, you can also do the same thing. Bring it out a little bit, become bolder for you. Those that like the very skinny, you stretch it, become skinny. So, depends. So that's a bow tie. Thank you. Hope you learned something today here on Fashion Trendz. That's all we can take today here on this program. Don't forget to keep following us on all our social media platforms on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, and TikTok. And please, most importantly, please subscribe our YouTube channel and click on the notification button to get the videos whenever we upload one. Very important. And also, importantly, please download our app on the Google Play Store. Please, we have a lot of films, we have a lot of documentaries, we have a lot of entertainment there for you. So do that and you'll be glad to do. So see you next time here on Fashion Trendz. My name is Michael Young. Have a great and a beautiful week. Bye for now.